welcome to Heartfully Creating. Today we're going to be using paint pens again, surprise, surprise. And this is going to be doodling on stretch canvas using a variety of the affordable pens. This is sort of my way of reviewing them. So I hope you enjoy it.
All right, it's a beautiful day. Decided to come outside and try doodling with my acrylic art pens. I am using Flymax. Flymax, it only comes in white. So I had bought a box of white. That's one of the first sets I bought. So I don't know how good this is gonna work because, yeah, the sun is pretty bright. But I'll try doing it here and just holding the camera and just start doodling. So just get it going, shake it up. We had an amazing thunderstorm yesterday, if you're interested. Just posted it on the Free Creation YouTube channel. If you're watching this, you're there anyway. But I linked it up with the Walking Way Overrated vlog, which is more like a vlog of our lives than this one is Heartfully Creating, which is to do with creativity. And hopefully it's not already dried up. See, sometimes if they seem like they're clogged, just keep moving it back and forth. Just definitely with the paint pens, you don't want to leave them uncapped, because just like all acrylic paint, be it using with a brush, which is what I grew up, it hardens. And once it hardens, you cannot reconstitute acrylic. That's it. I have been actually really, really enjoying a new YouTube channel that I discovered called Peter Draws. And it's Peter Draws, like Peter actually draws. And see, look at that shadow. Oh well, we'll just have some fun doodling. I have to say I've been inspired by this fellow. He's an artist on YouTube who has lots of really fun videos. And his he's inspired me to actually try again working with fountain pens. Now, years and years ago, probably about 20 years ago, I went with my grandma, who went to heaven way back in the 80s. We took a calligraphy course together. For anyone who doesn't know, calligraphy is just a really fancy way to draw with a pen and ink. But back then they started, I think it was the Schaefer Company that I remember, came out with a, anyone know about quill painting? Like writing with quills, like in the old days, you get like a feather and then you carefully, actually on the Townsend channel, they show all about that and the invention of ink and what they used and how to make a quill pen using a feather and all that stuff. And, yeah, so that was like early, pen and ink writing and stuff like that. But calligraphy is like making fancy letters and writing fancy and all of that stuff. So, I'm getting distracted. Okay, so way back with my dear grandma, Harris, I got to take a calligraphy class with her at my very small hometown of, at that time, 500 people. And, 500 people, and it was like a weekend class at the current the community center, and it was really lots of fun. But the materials then, it was, they still have those the calligraphy pens where the tip is like flat and thin, and sorry that you're gonna hear traffic and stuff, flat and thin, and yeah, so you have thick and thin lines and you just have lots of fun making really pretty lettering. Lettering that's often used on certificates and, you know, things like that, like graduation certificates. And and the problem is, though, it just, I don't know, I guess I just gave it up. It didn't last very long. I was into it for a while. I bought parchment paper and stuff like that. But you needed to have the cartridges of ink, because I, unlike our forefathers, and those who are into it now, who use something called dip pens, which were the pens where you actually dip them in the ink. I tried that in drawing, in our art making methods. by drawing with a dip pen. So in that case, it was like a very fine point, but extremely scratchy. So I would find, and blobby. I really, really, really got frustrated. Charcoal and dip pens were two things that I did not ever really enjoy drawing with. I tried it in different disciplines and classes and sketching, drawing classes and things like that. But yeah, it was just too messy. Charcoal, oh, some beautiful charcoal artists out there, but I don't know how they do it. It's like chalk pastel, love the stuff, but can't work with it because it's just way, way too messy. Same with dip pens. So dip pens, never even, I think I did try drawing with it years and years and years ago, decades ago, and it was just too blob. Like you go to use it and it would just catch in the paper and then just leave a big blob of ink and be all messy. So now, after watching on the Peter Draws channel, binge watching it a lot, my husband likes him too because he's really funny. He's got a really cool sense of humor, and he's just a really funny guy, and he's inspired a lot of people. You can tell, I can see why, like inspired their creativity. He's read some of the letters that some people have written, and he's not arrogant in any way, shape, or form. He's just a really neat guy with a good sense of humor and a good heart. And he actually did that, has a few good videos on art appreciation. And basically, going through a lot of the paintings that I remember from my art history class about just liking, like who you want, like what you want. Don't let people kind of, you know, bully you into like this painting because blah, blah, blah. And I remember that. I remember in art history class and working at a gallery at myself. And basically, I felt like I was kind of being talked into liking a painting that our country bought by someone called Barnett Newman called The Voice of Fire. And I just remember thinking, I was with the rest of the public going, ugh, yeah, Canada paid $1 million for that. And all it is like red and blues, like three stripes. How can that be art? And my boss at the time explained to me, she was I think a few days older than me, explained to me very well, mind you, why it was good art. And that's it. I don't know. So I made a trip to Ottawa. I got to go see it in person. I really tried to enjoy it. But the way Peter talks, he does discuss it in a way that he's right. There are people where it feels like you're told and talked into liking a piece of art because someone else tells you to. Because there's people who are experts or think they're experts, where really, it really is, they're just their best guess.
I'm gonna do a little experiment. I'm doing this, I don't know, call it a graffiti drawing. I'm using my teeth again to open up marker lids. So don't do this at home, kids. Okay, so this is the Artistro brand. I'm working in reverse here, so hopefully that works. Artistro, not focusing at all, is it? Nope, there we go. Okay, Artistro. Now, I don't like, one of the things when you're doing any kind of composition, you want to think about your color usage. Right now I'm finding this really, I don't know, it's got words in it, and words are a very strong focal point because we recognize words, right? Because we can spell. Most of us can't say I can, but so far I've done the fruit of the Holy Spirit kind of intermixed in here, like words within some decorative stuff. But kindness is in purple, and all the other letters are in more of a complementary color, so they pop out more. So I just realized this just doesn't work. So I'm going to test these pens and see how well the coverage. So I'm going to try the different brands, and I've got all the colors that are as close to the same color. Oh, wow, that's pretty good. Wow, that's really good. Okay, so this is Artistro brand, and just I'm amazed at how good the coverage is already because I'm going over a fairly dark color with this lovely, I call it carmine red because I worked in Prismacolor pencils for a while, and I used a lot of carmine red, and that was this color. So it's not really, or maybe call it Carmen Red, or I'm going to lose my voice again. Great. Call it Cadmium Red Middle, Cadmium Red Deep, something like that. Oh, it's okay. Thanks, my husband's getting me some water. Thanks. Unfortunately, I don't think that'll help. I just seem to be getting old and losing my voice. So I'm going to do all the letters in different, three different brands that have the same, well, through the pen, they look the same. So, okay, now what happens if your pen is too wet and you start seeing streaks? I don't know if you could see that. I was getting some streaks. Then don't push as hard because the tip pushes away the paint when it hasn't hardened. But this is actually pretty good coverage for the first time down, because I would expect that it would be a little more transparent. And Craig's sitting here at the table. He's inspired because earlier we were watching a channel. Oh man, I can't remember his name. Gurney. He's an artist, and he does like outdoor real life or still life, but actual real life, not from photos, not from his imagination. And Craig actually said he was inspired to paint. Not that he hasn't been painting, but he was inspired. So what are you thinking about painting, Craig?
Oh, I want to do a painting.
About what? You want to try real life or a photo at least? Because Craig does everything from his head, which is great. I can't do what he does, but he does it from his head. Ooh, I love that.
Well, I might want to do a house.
Yeah, houses are good. You're good at that. Well, you're good at lots of that stuff. Craig does landscapes really well. And you can check out the channel, the blog, HeartfullyCreating.blogspot.com to see. Actually, you never finally did like the grand finale of your painting that is still on your easel, which is of the railway.
Yeah, I haven't finished that yet.
So he needs to do that.
I was thinking of adding more color to it and making it a fall presentation.
Oh no, you're going to change it again? This is the thing. Craig's been working on this painting for months and months and months. Okay, there's the artistro. That's the coverage for that one.
That's the joy.
Pretty darn good.
Joy of painting.
Oops, and now I have a runaway lid. Thanks,
Greg. What's going on here? Look how great that
looks. It doesn't look great. To me, this looks too busy and too the purple. Oops.
Oh, no, that's the fruit of the spirit.
You want to keep the lids on these pens. I have a weak hand, so I push my pen, this part, against the table side, and then I lean up against it with my body to put the lid on. Okay, and now I'm going to try the one that I expect to have the least amount of coverage, which is, again, don't do this at home, kids. I'm using my teeth to pull the lid off. Yeah, not a good idea. But I don't have, I guess I could ask Craig for help. So I'm going to shake them. This is the Ohoohoo. The Ohoohoo. I like saying this because I'm not even sure if I'm saying it right, but it's not right. Ohoohoo. Oh, I see it in there. Ohoohoo. Okay. Now, I don't know. I'm guessing this is close to that color. See, of course, I'm going to have to do a second coat, but it's still, wow. The Ohoohoo were like the cheapest set of pens, and they came with actually a really wide range of colors, and they are a little more runnier, so you're going to shake them more, but they still work. I mean, I'm really impressed for the price that they were. So sorry, shake. You can hear that ball. This reminds me of the old days when I used to wear nail polish. Okay, just shake your, never mind. Let's not get back to flashbacks. Okay, so this is pretty close to the actually, this artist we were watching, he was using, I call it quinacrone. He's probably said it properly, but I can't even say it. Yeah, that red's a little bit different, but still good coverage. Pretty good coverage. Okay, so these paints, and that's what I'm trying to do. I still haven't put together all the reviews yet because I've been actually having problems with my computer telling me it's full. Because the memory is full, even though I've been deleting every possible thing that I can think of. Okay, now, because I want to make some videos, and I'm really disappointed that I've been getting messages of your hard drive is too full. So this is Heroic, and again, to me, this is probably the closest to the red that I want. you just start moving. Yeah, again, great coverage. These affordable pens are really great. I'm guessing that the Posca, you know how I feel about Posca, overpriced. However, the important thing about Posca, I guess, that people probably like is the assorted sizes of nibs or tips, where these ones, so far, I've only been able to get in the Eroic ones and even the Ohuhu ones. I think even Artistro. And I mean, they might be available, but so far I haven't really seen anything other than 0.07 tips. And then I do have some Thule Art ones, but I don't seem to have any Thule Arts in this color that are in this size. I did get a pack of Thule Art that are 3mm. So, okay, so the best way to find out is the same color. So again, good coverage for the first coat over top of a dark purple, and I can tell it's pretty close to that color. I'm just going to use the Eroic for the rest of it. So the Eroic, Ohuhu, Eroic, Ohuhu, and Artistro. So I'm just going to take, since I've got the Eroic open, I'm just going to touch it up with that. Shake, 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 shake. Okay. And if you go to shake your pen and it doesn't, the ball, you don't hear it, then keep shaking. Because until that ball moves, it's not shaken properly. And even then, when you go to use it, you want to make sure that the ball is actually moving. And if you're not getting enough paint, you just pump it a little bit. But don't over pump it. The other day, oh, right. I don't know if I'm going to make a video about this or not, because it might be boring now that I know the results. I was using the new Thule Art oil-based 3mm, I don't even know. They're thicker than this. On the table outside, I was painting on glass because it's supposed to be good for that. So, don't you just love red and purple together? I know I do. But anyway, I digress. So, I was using that on the glass table outside, and thinking, because it says it can go on glass, and I've heard that, oh, use oil paint on outdoor things because it lasts longer, but it didn't. We had a really good rainstorm with some little hail, and sure enough, the paint already started to chip. So much for that theory. I guess I should do an experiment and try some acrylic. If I was a betting person, I would say that the acrylic would peel even faster, because acrylic on a smooth surface peels. Like, it peels on plastic. That's why I'm surprised when I see so many people. That last video, first video clip for this part, was done in the high quality. Still trying to learn how to use this camera properly. Forgot to change it to not. We don't need it as high quality as I had it on. And it only lets you film for 10 minutes or it overheats. Okay, so again, we're just filling this all in. And see how it pops next to the teal or turquoise or whatever you want to call it. I really, really do like violet or purple with bright red. And Craig's back. He's doing laundry. Craig's the laundry guy. That's what he does. He does all the mostly all the housework, except for my personal care attendants do the floors and help me and other stuff that Craig can't do physically, because as I think you know, if you watch the channel, he uses a wheelchair as well. So, but he has what I call healthy muscles, so he does all the other stuff. These days he does all the cooking. I try to give directions. He does all that. Okay, so this on camera, red really flares out. I find it's very, very bright, and it can kind of, I know we watch movies on our high definition TV and it's still, red seems to get distorted almost, like it doesn't, I don't know, it's weird. You think with high definition it would show perfectly, but it's not. It's actually doing a weird flashy red, like almost like it's lifted off the screen, like it's not good quality. Like that you can't see the detail. It's weird. There is something about red, and about like newscasters and whatnot, people who wear red. It's not really a good idea to wear red because it just does something on the screen. And it translates into, oops, okay, that I'll be cleaning up later with a white pen, but there, you get the idea. So now I'll go over that and clean it up. I don't want to bore you with going through all of this again. And I just like to not make colors flat by adding different variations of other colors over top to create a bit of depth and interest. That's something that you want to do. So this whole thing is not done, and I'm going to not bore you with it. So I just wanted to experiment using those different brands to see how the coverage was, and then just talk a little bit about that. So there you go. Stopping by. I hope you're inspired a little to try creating using paint pens. And if you don't have paint pens, don't let that restrict you or limit you. You can use whatever makes marks on paper. So, and if you like the video, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and happy creating.